Good evening, friends. I have a problem. I'm running out of room. Running out of room on these shelves for my collection. Take a look at this.
Fool. We got extra up here. I really don't know what to do with. Same with those two. Fool. So that leads me to a crossroads. What can I do? What should I do? I've decided to sell everything. I'm just joking. I wouldn't do that. What y'all thinking? Y'all know me. I've decided to reorganize these shelves to see if we could rearrange and make room for new titles. Okay, this is going to be a long and grueling task, but hopefully I can get some joy out of it, and I would love to document the whole thing. Just get some personal time with the collection. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? So this is going to be a multi-day task. I'm just going to work on it little by little and update y'all along the way. Because I don't have all the time in the world to just be sitting in here reorganizing things. So it's going to be fun. It's going to be fun. It's going to be, it's a lot. Now, at the end of it, I might still just not have space. We'll see. But my hope is to reorganize some things, put some specific genres and things together just so that we can make some room in other areas. I don't know. You'll see what I'm talking about after we get started. But this is going to be the beginning of this journey. So come along with me. Okay, so as you can see here, there really isn't much of a rhyme or reason for most of the collection here. I kind of just threw it all on this shelf just to have it on there. And then this shelf I've just been filling up as I get more. And now I'm out of room. So, as you can see here, up here we have some box sets, some 4Ks, some boutique stuff, steelbooks, just some of my favorite pieces in the collection, some of the bigger things. Down below here, we do have the MCU in order, in chronological order, and then we've got some more Marvel stuff and some more Disney, with Pixar joining the mix, as well as Star Wars and Disney animation. So really just kind of my Disney shelf, I guess. With some more animated films here. You know, just trying to keep it light. But then we just kind of go off the rails at this point. Just start throwing all of our Blu-rays on. Down here, we've got some horror. I tried to keep those together. But obviously, I don't have enough to fill an entire shelf. So it just started going off the rails here. Also, just a bunch of random things. I've got a little section right here of DC for some reason. I don't know. And then down here, just a continuation of Blues, as well as the beginning of our DVD collection. So, yeah, I mean, like I said, it's not really organized or in order at all. We do have our horror DVDs down here at the bottom shelf. And of course, I've got too many of those to just fill up one shelf, so I put some up here, which is mixed in with Scooby-Doo, of course, and Friday, you know, horror. But then we've got, on the back side, some games. We've got our PS4 games here at the top, as well as PS3 over in the corner, PS2, Xbox 360, and kind of getting into Xbox One. Down here, like I said before, most of this area back here are hand-me-downs from my parents' collection. So these are kind of some animated films, a lot of Barbie here,
and just some family films. So I got that going on here, but then it kind of morphs as we get further in to some other kind of things. Stops being just animated and family films. You can see we've got Paranormal Activity down here, and there's a Blu-ray in this section. And then at the lower couple shelves, we've got some box sets and some just random things down here. So that's the goal for this, is to kind of just clean up some of this stuff, start putting it together, and to where it's cohesive and things make sense. So we're going to start probably with this shelf over here, just because it's less grueling and smaller, just to help my stress levels. We've also got some box sets up here. I'll probably just keep all those there. I don't really see a reason to move those around. But yeah, we're going to get started. As we begin with this shelf, I'm kind of wanting to make this one kind of our box set shelf as well as VHS. So as you can see down here, we've already got a lot of VHS tapes on this shelf. But then just some random stuff up here. I'd really just want to keep these here, move some of these box sets onto that shelf, as well as these, just because they take up a lot of space. And I mean, this would be the perfect place for them, just because this is kind of a display shelf, to have all of our box sets together that aren't necessarily big enough to throw up there, just because those are our larger of the bunch. So that's where we will begin. I'll update you along the way. All right, so we've cleaned this up just a bit. We've taken our Blu-rays and DVDs off, and we've got a little stack running right here. I've kept the VHS on just because I'll probably keep those there, as well as throw our new VHS down there. So yeah, let's go ahead and throw some of these box sets, some of these smaller box sets, on this shelf. Update here for you, friends. Look at what we've done. We have updated this display shelf. So we've got our sets and our VHS tapes all displayed here, as well as we've cleaned up the top a little bit, took a set from there, threw it down there, one of our Alfred Hitchcock sets, and we threw the High Noon set up there. So we're making progress. We are making progress. And that actually cleared up a lot of space. So we've got some space for our any new tapes that we get, as well as it cleaned up a lot of space on this top shelf and some of these other shelves. I mean, we've got some more space for things. So that's really exciting. Now, I do have a lot more sets, but they're all like shows, and I really want to keep all the shows together, and I kind of want to make this more of the movie and miniseries type shelf. So yeah, next we're gonna tackle some of this stuff, see what we can get on there. Okay, so I've changed my mind on the shelf since the last clip. I've also got a haircut since the last clip, about 30 minutes ago, honestly. So this is the same day. Check out what I've done with this shelf now. So what I have decided is to make this kind of my... of course, we've got a couple sets up here. But on this first shelf are all Criterions. We've got some Olive, some Arrow, some Scream Factory, Kino. So basically these couple shelves are my boutiques, specifically Criterion on that shelf. And then this shelf down here, we've got some sets, yes. However, most of these are, the rest of these are 4K. And then we've got our Steelbooks right here, as well as VHS tapes on the bottom too. So these are kind of my, this is my specialty shelf, I guess, with... we've got Scream Factory release of
Friday box set, Alfred Hitchcock VHS set, boutiques, and some 4Ks and steelbooks VHS. So, yeah, specialty shelf here. I've got some more sets up here. Kind of put those on the top, which is kind of nice for now, I guess. And I think I'm going to make this top shelf my Disney shelf. As much as I don't necessarily want to do that, it's the most accessible, and I think it's probably the most that I have of one company. So stay tuned. I'm changing all this up. So we've still got a lot of work to do. Put my Abbott and Costello back up there. So yeah, y'all stay tuned. All right. Everybody calm down. We've done it. At least we've done it for the most part. I'm satisfied with what we've got for now. I will be kind of shifting and rearranging things probably, you know, just constantly. But for the time being, I'm pretty satisfied with what we've got going. So let's check it out. Okay, friends, we are back. This little project of mine isn't taking near as long as I expected it to. But what we have done is we have taken every movie off the shelves and returned them to the shelves in a grouping kind of organization. I still have to go through and reorganize by specifics. So I'm not finished, but I'm close. All I've got to do is just jump in there and move some things around. But it has cleaned up a lot of space. So check this out. So first, we do have this. Whoa, we've got this section here. Boutiques cleared up a lot. I've got a lot of space in these areas to fill in. Here we've got, of course, the sets up top. We have moved all of the Disney down. I decided, you know what, I want to do what I like at the top. So we've got horror up here, the Blu-ray horror, and then it goes into DVD, which is more prominent. And this entire row is horror, as well as almost all of that. So we do, though, have a lot of space here. And now we've got our Disney row here. And it goes into movies. So yeah, it kind of cuts off right here. And then regular Blu-rays begin. And yeah, we've still got some room down there. So that's exciting. Now, on the back, we have made more changes. Whew, excuse me. So I've taken all the rest of the games off. So I just have my PS4 games up here just because I play that the most on my PS5 also. And I took most of these. So I've still got a few PS3 games here. I took all of the PS2 off. I took all of the Xbox off just to make some more room. So now these are just random DVDs. There's a couple sets over here. I'm still figuring out what to do with this row. But that's a lot of extra space to fill in. And then I still need to reorganize this back half. But we're getting there. That bottom row is, it's honestly pretty good. It shows. But I will just kind of rearrange some of this stuff here. Now all the games we took and put them in the closet. So they've got their own little space. So that's fun. And little sneak peek here of some blank VHS tapes that I'm hopefully going to be getting into soon. Now, that's what we've done so far. But we're not finished. Of course, we have to organize specifics. So join me as we do a deep dive. All right, so we'll start up here at the top. Now, we've got High Noon, the VHS box set. We've thrown that up top. Batman, Abbott and Costello. We've got our Fast and Furious set here. Looking pretty. Of course, we've got this. Scoob, Friday, Pops,
Jump down here. We've got our Alfred Hitchcock VHS set. Friday Scream Factory set. And these are our boutiques. So we've got Criterion here on the top shelf with a little sneaky, sneaky. The greatest movie ever made right there. Wonderful. We've got our other various boutiques down here. These couple, Olive Signature. And we've got Arrow beginning here with Killer Clowns. And then it goes through to Kino. We've got our Kino Flicks beginning here. And then we've got some more Scream Factory. Along with, I had to put my Halloween Steelbook with the Halloween box set. I just had to. So we've got that there. And then we've got some other various sets down here. And then we get our 4Ks started. And I had to put the Room 237 DVD with The Shining. Of course. Of course I had to do that. So I will say I wanted to keep all of my Kong and Godzilla movies together, but I don't know. I kind of like, same with all the DC EU films and just DC in general and Nolan films. I've got a couple on 4K and Disney even. I wanted to keep everything together on my other shelves, but I don't know. I like the way 4K is looking all together. So I threw them up there. Steelbooks down here, and then we begin our VHS section with this beautiful thing right there. Isn't that cool? Isn't that awesome? I can't remember if I've shown that yet or not. But then we go down here, and we've got some more VHS room. So opened up a big chunk right there, a lot of space right there, and some more room to fill in some of these boutique and 4K titles. So we've got Rufus, classic. And then we'll jump up here at the top with our Hitchcock, the rest of our Hitchcock collection. Got that there. I've got a lot of Hitchcock. you haven't been able to tell already. Pride and Prejudice, my wife's two sets together. Got our James Dean set here with his films. The Nightmare set, and then Indiana Jones, and our 007 films. Now, I did something completely different with the rest of this here. Okay, let me zoom out just a little bit. So, I did my horror in order of release. So, that's exciting. Kind of a history of horror type deal. So we begin here with the Golem. Now this is a Kino release, so it should be over there, but I don't know. My system's weird, but it's how I work. It's how I like it. So we begin with the Golem here. 1915, if I'm not mistaken. 1920 there. So that is the earliest film I do have in the collection currently. And then we continue this direction in chronological order. And I did decide to go ahead and throw DVDs and Blu-rays together just because it looks kind of cool. Oh, and one thing I did is it's in order up until, like, you know, we get Friday or Texas Chainsaw. This is the Steelbook version, but then we get Texas Chainsaw 2. So that didn't come out, you know, directly after the first one. It was a few years. So what I did is I took the year of the first movie in each of the series that I have and just put the rest of the series together with it, and did it that way. It makes sense for me. I love that. I love to keep my series together, franchises together. So we've got Texas Chainsaw here. We've got some Halloween here that isn't a part of that set, as well as a couple just original Halloween releases, just separate releases. But yeah, that's kind of how I did it. Did it in chronological order, and then I took all of the franchises and just put them together based upon the release date of their first film. Then we get down here to the early 2000s. And we're starting to see a lot less Blu-ray until we get to the newer films here. And I put the Purge series with the films. So, and then down here, and then here we start our big kind of set collections where we go through to here. And then I began another little section of Christmas horror. So that's fun. And then we jump into zombie or undead. And then my favorite found footage begins here with the McPherson tape. Now, right next to those, we do have the Planet of the Apes collection. So we've got the Legacy collection here with the original series. And then we've got the Mark Wahlberg and, of course, the Rise, Dawn, and War trilogy right next to it. I don't know. I'm kind of confused on where to put that. That's definitely not going to be in the horror section, but for now, I'm just keeping it there. We might figure out a place for it, maybe up top somewhere. Actually, yeah, let's see how that's going to look. Let's just do this with me, friends. Isn't this fun? Let's see. So that's got four. Okay, let's see. Oh, yikes, that's tight. Okay, hang on a second. What am I doing? Zoom's over a bit. All right. I move that over just a smidge. Grab this. Okay. That fits. And then we will grab. Those. I don't know. That's awful tall. Let's see what we're thinking here. I don't know about it, Chief. Okay, so this is our Amazon. It's not even plugged in. Haven't done anything with that yet. So what if we took this? Oops. Hold that there for now. This is just the uncut behind the scenes. This is what y'all came for, ain't it? Let's see. Move these here. Do like that there. Okay. Throw this in the corner. Oh, there's something back there. Okay, hang on a second. We'll be right back. We're back, friends. All right, let's see what we've done. Okay, so here's what we've got. Right? I don't know. I'm okay with it. Okay, so let's continue. So now we've got a big space right here for more horror. Ooh, it's nice. Down here, we've got our Marvel MCU. Going through here. And then it jumps into some more Marvel related. So Spider-Man, the Venomverse, into the Spider-Verse. And then we've got some more Disney-owned properties, our Pixar collection here. And then it jumps into Lucasfilms with Star Wars. And some of just our Disney animation And then down here, some more Disney, and then we jump into some more Disney live action. Now here we've got our Christmas collection, which is fun. Our non-horror Christmas collection. And then some action. We've got our John Wicks with Kingsman, and then we've got Rocky. We've got the Lord of the Rings franchise, Sherlock, and then our Godzilla section is a little small because we've got one over there, and then our DC collection. And then this morphs from DC into our Nolan series, which is fun. I don't have every Christopher Nolan movie, but I've got most of them. And then we go into our war movies and then just some randos. Now, this bottom row is still just some random Blu-ray, just the rest of my Blu-ray. So, yeah, but we do have a little bit of room here to add on. So that's fun. Now let's jump to the back side. We've got our PS4 and some PS3 here. And of course, we've got some room as well for some extra. And we do have, the back of our sets here, which is fun. Creepy Hitchcock there. I wonder if we... Let's just put this Hitchcock set up next to that Planet of the Apes set and finish the face. Oh my gosh, I'm an idiot. Okay. Yep, so we've got our games here. And here begins more of our kids/family section. Get a bunch of Barbie movies here. And then some Nickelodeon with our SpongeBob series, as well as the first two movies. I don't have the third one yet. And then we've got a bunch of Scooby-Doo movies. I'm looking to collect all of those soon. I was debating on putting these up there with our Scooby-Doo set, but it's just too much. It's too much. We've got What's New Scooby-Doo Season 1 and 2 out of order here. So let me just fix that. But just missing Season 3 on that series, which isn't a super big deal. DreamWorks collection here, and then we've got the DreamWorks ends with the bad guys here. And then we jump into some more just random animated with Illumination here, and just some other fun treats. And then just more of our family-oriented movies here with the Turtles franchise. And then down below, we do have our Austin Powers set together, which would go nicely with our Bond set, but it's a bit colorful to put up there with that white. And then we've just got our other, just kind of random, the rest of our DVDs. I didn't really want to go through these right now and sort all of them, but yeah. There you have it, friends. That's what we've done. And then some of our newer additions down here. Oh, and I did, for some reason, put these three Batman movies together. That's pretty much, other than the Dark Knight series and our Adam West series there, that's all the Batman I've got. So I'd like to collect the rest of those soon. Maybe in the bigger box set with these. Whoops. Now, down below this last shelf, of course, we've got our series. And I tried to put them kind of, I don't know. I did a random weird thing here with these. So, yeah. There you have it. Oh. And down here, we've got just some holiday flicks. Some family holiday fun. With Easter, we've got some Halloween. I guess that's not technically Halloween, but I mean, fair. Halloween related, and then we've got Valentine's Day, which is fun. So, heck yeah, man. That's what we've got going on the shelves. One more pan through.
So that's what we have. I'm really pleased with how this turned out. I'm giddy. I really love just the fact that I was able to put my horror kind of all together, and they're chronological, but also with each of the franchises. So I'm really happy about that. What I would love to do next with the collection, because I love making these collection videos. I don't know, it's a bit more personal and something I love. I'd love to go through every movie that I've got. It's going to be a large video. I might not talk about them, might not talk about every single one in depth, but I would love to just show y'all, just kind of pull some stuff out and talk about it with you. So that's what we've got now. I'm still collecting, of course. I just actually bought a few things today from a pawn shop that I don't have on this, the shelf yet. But yeah, it's a good time. I had fun with this video. So it took a while to kind of get everything together, but I'm pleased with it. I'm pleased for now. So I've got some ideas of things I want to switch around, maybe switch the Disney section up a bit, and I don't know. But we'll see what happens. I'll keep y'all posted. And until next time, when the streetlight comes on, come on home, y'all.